Hi folks, Thomas Henson here with thomashenson.com, and today is another episode of Big Data, Big Questions. And so today's question I'm going to tackle is about web development to machine learning engineer. So what I want to talk about is, how do you become a machine learning engineer if you've got a background with web development? So not only am I going to talk about my journey on it, but I'm also going to give you three tips for making that journey if you're a web developer thinking about that. So find out more right after this. And we're back. And so today's question that we're going to tackle is about web development moving into machine learning engineer. But before we tackle that, I want to encourage everybody out there, if you have any big data related questions or any questions in general, just go ahead, throw them in the comment section here below, or go to my website, thomashenson.com/big-questions. Submit your questions there. I will answer them here on YouTube. Really love the engagement. I love being able to get out in front of the community. So just keep bringing those in. And then if you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe to my YouTube channel. That way you never miss an episode of Big Data, Big Questions or some of the other cool things I'm doing with interviews, book reviews, and just general technology awesomeness, right? So let's jump into the question for today. And so today's question comes in about how do you transition from a web developer to a machine learning engineer? So one of the reasons behind this is, you know, talked about it. I had a video where we talked about what the machine learning engineer is. Huge, huge hot topic area. A lot of people are looking into, you know, how they become a data engineer or a machine learning engineer. So there's a lot of interest there in the web development community. You know, maybe there's, you know, a lot of people that are out there looking and they're saying, hey, you know, I kind of want to be on that bleeding edge. I want to see what all's going on with this machine learning engineer. How do I get into that? What, you know, is that even possible, right? You know, I'm sitting here creating, you know, maybe some C-sharp development applications, or, you know, maybe you're a PHP developer, ASP.NET, you know, any genre there, maybe just a general JavaScript, you know, maybe you're a node engineer and you're wanting to really branch out and look kind of what's into that. So before we jump into the three tips, I'm going to give you three tips for how you can do that. I want to tell you that it is possible. So my journey into big data, I was a ASP.NET developer. And so this was quite a few years back. It was in the early days of the Hadoop community. So I was involved starting in Hadoop 1.0. And so for me, I was a contractor and we were coming to the end of a project that I'd been working on for many years. And I was looking, kind of trying to see what else was out there. And one of the projects that was out there was a data analytics project. And I knew that it was kind of going to be, you know, real heavy in research and kind of on the cutting edge. So I really started looking into it. As I got more involved in it, I started learning about Hadoop and I learned about, you know, some of the things that they were doing as a community. And so I really got sparked from that point. But I mean, it is possible. So it's something that, you know, I was able to do. There was a lot of things I had to learn, and there were a lot of things that if I could go back, I would have learned first, right? I would have done it a little bit different. But so my journey here now is because of all those, you know, trials and tribulations that I went to. But the cool thing is I get to share some of those for anybody out there that's a web developer trying to look into it, or anybody that's just getting started. But today I want to focus on the web developer. So your skills are going to translate, right? But there's going to be some gaps and some things that you need to do. So if you're a web developer looking out there and you're saying, hey, how do I jump in? How do I transition into a machine learning engineer? And so you want to be involved with the algorithms and some of the, you know, and the day-to-day development activities for these huge, massively machine learning projects or deep learning or AI. How can you get involved? So my first tip, you might not like this one, but the first thing you need to do, don't cheat and don't do the other steps first. Take 2 weeks, 30 minutes a day, and start learning about linear regression and linear algebra. And there's a ton of free resources out there. You can go to Coursera. They have some free courses on it. You can, you know, opt in to take the certificate to get certified. A lot of things on YouTube. So you can go through some daily training on YouTube. There's a lot of different blog posts out there. Just take 30 minutes to go through the math portion. So the math and statistics are going to be one of the gaps that you're going to lack. And so that's one of the things. I didn't take any of the formal courses. I just kind of went back and started looking at some of my old college notes, just trying to figure it out. But I would go through, and if you have the time, so if you don't, if you know, go through the 2 weeks, watch some YouTube videos, some blog posts, go to Coursera, you know, sign up for a course if you're involved in a portal site. or any of the other online trainings out there. Find any resources there. Take it. Do it for 2 weeks. Also, maybe, these are pretty big careers. Maybe sign up for a course, you know. So if you're in college right now, take a linear regression course. If you're not in college and you have the opportunity, I don't see why you wouldn't want to do something like that. So, you know, if this is a path that you're kind of going down and really serious about. So I know it's not the most fun part of it, but I promise you it's going to help you down the road understanding the terminology and the math behind what we're doing. So even if you're not looking to be a data scientist, so we've talked about it here before, data scientist versus data engineer, this is more the data engineer, but you're still going to want to have that math background. Tip number two, you want to take 2 weeks, maybe three, but 2 weeks for sure, 30 minutes a day, so you're starting to see a trend here. You want to walk through the Hadoop or Spark tutorials. And so you want to learn and understand how to do those. Do the basic tutorials. I'm not talking about, you know, standing up your own full Hadoop cluster in your own data center. I'm saying go through the tutorials with the sandbox. There's a ton of resources out there. I have a lot of Pluralsight courses that base around having just a little bit of SQL knowledge and a little bit of Linux knowledge, and that will help you kind of go through it. But there are other resources out there too. I'm not, you know, obviously I'd encourage you and love for you to, you know, join in and watch some of my Pluralsight courses, but there's a ton of resources out there. This is a huge community. Coursera has, you know, some baseline courses. You can find things on YouTube. I've got a ton of free resources on my blog that you can just walk through. So if you like walking through the tutorial, grabbing some of the code, I've got a ton of tutorials and a ton of just basic command line stuff that you can do to start learning the Hadoop and Spark. So I would just take, you know, like I said, 30 minutes a day, not too much of an ask. You can download one of the sandboxes, whether it comes from Cloudera or from Hortonworks. They'll have Hadoop installed with it and also have Spark. You can run through some of the basic tutorials. Ton of resources out there. Like I said, I've got a Pluralsight course. I've got quite a few Pluralsight courses actually around that. But take the time and go through that. So we've gone through the math portion, and now we've gone through just learning the baseline of some of the bigger data stuff. Now let's get into some of the machine learning. So now you get to use your skills, your background with JavaScript, and I would start looking into Tensorflow.js. And so Tensorflow.js is the machine learning in the browser. So TensorFlow, if you're not familiar, I've kind of talked through it here a little bit around why it's awesome. But TensorFlow released by Google, it's really, really popular right now in the big data community, especially around machine learning and deep learning. And so there are some really cool features in it, but there's a lot of stuff that you can do with it from the browser perspective. So this is TensorFlow.js. And so this is where your background and you get to shine. So go through the tutorials, but don't skip the other steps, but go through the tutorials, start playing with the Pac-Man interface that they have, do the pitch curve. So is it a fastball or is it a curveball? And now you're going to understand some of that math because you did step one first, right? You didn't cheat. You know, I know everybody right now is looking on the browser like, hey, I'm going to TensorFlow.js right now. It's a really cool resource. But you're going to understand the math behind it, and this is going to get you started. And so now that you've got the math background in it, and you've also got the ability to say, hey, you know, if we wanted to stand this up and put this, you know, in some kind of distributed system, whether it be Hadoop or whether it be, you know, just understanding some of the baseline of Spark, you have that knowledge background too. And so you've done all this probably in 6 weeks, and, you know, it gives you an opportunity to start looking and start understanding. And maybe there's some projects internally, you know, in your organization that you can look for, or maybe, you know, it's something that you're trying to look for, you know, further down the road. Maybe you're in college right now looking to do it. By doing some of these steps right now, you're really setting yourself up for success. Well, thanks again. Hope everyone got a lot of information from this. Hope you're going out there and learning linear algebra, and you can also play that Pac-Man game on TensorFlow.js. Any questions, make sure you submit them. Until next time, thanks.